All right, guys, I'm going to try to talk really loud over the noise of the lawnmower. The purpose of this exercise is to do obedience with Bear off leash with multiple distractions, real life distractions. I know we make distractions and then we post that, but this is real life. We got four gentlemen across the street cutting the grass. They're riding lawnmowers, they're weeding, they're having a blow dryer, blower, whatever. And it's a lot of noise. It's a lot of people. It's a lot of commotion. So the purpose of this video is to proof Bear off leash through these distractions and continue to give him verbal commands to see if he'll listen, or will he get spooked? Will he run off? Will he get scared? Right? He's never seen these men before. These tools, these machines are very loud, and I want to continue to give him verbal commands through this. Now, this is proofing a dog completely off leash, no treats, and giving him commands with drivers and lawnmowers and random people in the backyard. If you didn't know Bear before this video, he was extremely skittish of new places, things, and place and people. So this is really good to show to the client that you actually proofed their dog, you actually trained them in commands, they're actually listening to those commands, and you can do it with or without treat. And your dog is not going to become reactive and go bite someone and act crazy. This is extremely important. It's proof that you did proof the dog, okay? So, also in this, you'll see Bear playing with Enoch. Then you'll see Bear and Enoch social around with cats. You'll see the whole variety, okay? I understand that people are into protection dogs and he's not biting and doing crazy things, so it may not mean much. This is for living lifestyle with Bear inside of a home, okay? This is what this is. This has absolutely nothing to do with gripping and biting and being a monster dog. This is all about this dog's behavior inside and outside the home. There are multiple people in the field. There are multiple people across the street. He is completely off leash. He is not becoming reactive. He's not acting fearful. And he's not trying to run off and do anything crazy. Point blank. So if you have your dog, the question you have to ask yourself, could you do this with your dog right now? Could you take your dog outside off leash, give him hand signals, give him verbal commands, and they not become reactive and run off and go try to bite the guy across the street, or they are being fearful and try to run back in the house, or they try to run away because they're, you know, you don't have them on leash. So once you answer those three prongs, you can say, yes, my dog would. No, my dog wouldn't. Now I understand why this video is important. Make sense? So that was the objective of this training session, and that's what we did. And I'm extremely proud with this training session and the trainers all involved that it took to get this dog this route. And, you know, it just gets better from here. So we will see you guys soon. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And reach out and contact us if you have any questions about dog training and or anything else. We will be here to completely answer those questions and get to you about your dog. Thank you for watching Madison Bell. We hope to see you guys soon and your puppy, and tell you about the things we can do to help you out if you need help.
So I am Simba.
Down.
Grim, come here.
Bear, come here. Bear. You're knocked down. Bear down. Like no one see you bitch up there. He's such a clown.
Yo, Grim almost got slapped.